Welcome. Welcome to another episode of All About Code, the show for Xbase++, Clipper, and Visual Foxport developers and users. My name is Frank, and I am your today's host. I would like to migrate a first Clipper application over to Xbase++, and I would like you to show where to start and how to hopefully succeed. And so I have decided for a Clipper application which you already have on your hard drive, DBU, the database utility which comes with Clipper with full source code. So please have a look on my desktop. What have we got? With Clipper you are working in a shell. So I have copied all the files to a directory and all's in there. So what Clipper am I using? I'm using Clipper 5.2e. So I compile all PHEs. I will link all the objects to an executable. And in the end, I would expect a DBU executable, which is 16-bit. But it runs on 16-bit DOS systems, and it will run on a 32-bit Windows operating system. It will not run on a 64-bit operating system. So I compiled it, I linked it, so I have a DBU exe. I start it, open the table, browse through the table. So that's all you know from DBU. Okay, so I want to have this specific project to be migrated to Xbase++. Where to start? At the very beginning, I would like you to open the Xbase++ Workbench. The Workbench is the central tool of Xbase++. It contains everything you need to work with Xbase++. So I would like to, or the first thing you have to do is to create a new project. In this very specific project, I would like to ask you to choose for a Windows target, and it should be a console application. The console application is the type of application which replaces the text mode application from Clipper. So I call the project DBU, XPP DBU, and it's instantly generated. The project has all the default settings. So it also comes with a main PHG, which we do not need because we do already have all the PHGs from our DBU project. Start Explorer. So I copy all the files from my Clipper DBU project. I also include a test DBF to show if it will work with Xbase++. I copy all those files to the directory where the Xbase++ project is. I just open Explorer, copy in all my files. That's all I need for the DBU project to be migrated to Xbase++. Okay, I right-click, I add existing files, and I throw into the project all my PHGs, which I just copied from the Clipper directory. So all the files are now in my Xbase++ project. If you click on the left-hand side, you see which functions or which procedure are implemented in which PHG. Okay. I would like to go the hard way with you, so I just jump into the cold water and build the project and see what happens. Okay. We are running in an error. The error says local declaration follows executable statement. local declaration follows executable statement. Ah, I see. I have a local statement here, and parameters is an executable statement. So this is not allowed with Xbase++. By the way, it should never have been allowed with Clipper. But we have to swap those two lines because the local declaration has to be first. It has to precede the executable statements. These errors, or these type of errors, will be 16 times within the DBU project. So I prepared myself again. And these are the three files which have those errors. I prepared them because I do not want you to watch me swapping lines 16 times. So I copy the files which I prepared, throw them into my project, replace the existing files. Of course, I have changed the file while open, so I have to reload it. Okay, so I just swapped 16 times the lines. So I built the project again. Ah, that's very good. Good news. All files seem to be compiling. Bad news, we have another error. The error says unresolved external symbol main. What does it mean? With Clipper, the program or the application entry point could be anything. You could call it any with any name. With Xbase++, it has to be main. So I have to change the DBU, which is the entry point for the DBU project, to main. That's it. I build the project again. So this looks better. We have all the files compiled and we have a DBU exe created successfully. By the way, just a comment, you see millions of warnings. The Xbase++ default project, which, because I did not change anything so far, this shows all the warnings. You could even switch it on with Clipper as well. So these are the warnings. Okay, now we have a DBU executable. Let's see if it runs. And it does, but again, I am not very happy with it. It runs, but it looks different to the Clipper executable. You see the space on the right-hand side. The space has not been existing with the Clipper application, but I want to have both looking the same and act the same. I want to have the very same experience. So I want to have it changed. What do I have to do, or what can I do with it? With Xbase++, there is a function that set mode. I have to define the rows. I decide for 25 because this is a typical Clipper mode, and to 80 columns. I build the project again and I run it again. As you see, the lines on the right hand side, or the space on the right hand side, has disappeared. So now the applications are looking the very same. They are working the same. Everything is the same. Except we are now in the 32-bit world. Now the Xbase++ executable is a 32-bit application. It will not run on Windows, on DOS, but it will run on Windows 64-bit. Because now the Xbase++ application is on a technically on a completely different level. Okay, so as you have seen, migrating our first project over from Clipper to Xbase ++ is quite an easy task. To read more about the issues, which are, because there are a few differences between Clipper and Xbase ++, but all of them are very well documented. So I want you to read through the lines. As you see, here we documented that you have to swap the local parameters lines. And there are not many issues. Read through them, adapt your code, or have a look if your code has such patterns. Change them to run with Xbase ++. So we even defined, or we even documented that you have that the program entry point has to be main. So read through those three chapters, and you know all the differences between Xbase ++ and Clipper. Okay, there's only one thing I want to have to do. Hold on. Copyright. I want to have it changed. Here we are. Thank you for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you can recreate, or you can migrate your own project over to Xbase ++. Otherwise, please send us an email and we help to our best. Thanks for watching the video. Bye bye, see you next time.